Welcome back to George Square. This one is another intriguing contest in the top section of the draw, Group B, and it's Chile against Northern Ireland. Both have had a great start to the tournament. Northern Ireland, really impressive. Chile too. Northern Ireland came through in second place in Group E, just behind Romania, and that was their only setback for Northern Ireland, coached by Terry Moore, managed by Justin McGinn. They lost on penalty shootouts to Romania. And this is Group B. This could be crucial for Northern Ireland, because later on they have their big contest against the Republic of Ireland, the big Irish derby. And Northern Ireland captained by Darren Spears, who is the linchpin of their side. And Tom Crosby is with me in the commentary box. Tom, you've had a good look at Northern Ireland already in this tournament. What have you made of them?
If there's a superstar in this tournament, if there is one player that people should tune in just to watch, if there's one team that revolves around any one man, it's Northern Ireland, and it's Spears, the number seven, the captain. He's been fabulous in the opening games, scoring goals for fun, tackling, tenacious, and with an incredible skill set. But it'll be interesting to see how he goes in this reign.
And here he is on the ball outside of the boot. He's joined on the field. Number one for Northern Ireland is Gavin McGuinness. Number five is Gerard Bannon. Six is Johnny Sterrett, another fine player in this Northern Ireland setup. And number seven, Darren Spears. But Chile, not to forget about them. They are a very, very tidy side. Nicolas Munoz is wearing the number three. And number five is Felipe Lepe. And number four, Matias Vilches. The goalkeeper for Chile is Jaime Duque. Here's Sterrett. Back to Spears. Well, it took a touch as it went over the top. Well, Spears showing he's got power in that boot as well. Here he is, constantly looking for the space for the shots. Well, how about that? You picked out the star man, and he delivers.
It's a fantastic start for Northern Ireland, and we've got to explain how good Chile are as well in this men's competition. We cannot underestimate them as a footballing force. They've beaten Slovenia 17-0 already. They've beaten Russia on penalties. The Chilean men's side have beaten England, who are quite strong, 10-1 already.
That's nicely done. Felipe Lepe, the number five, with the outside of the boot and knocking the ball past Gavin McGuinness. An opening 2 minutes that leave the mind intrigued as to what the next 12 will bring. That was a heavy challenge going in from Gerard Bannon. Well, it is Northern Ireland that get the free kick, because the initial challenge from the Chilean player was equally strong, and then a shove in the back from Johnny Sterrett.
What I think is really interesting about this match is that Grant Cameron in the Chilean goal hasn't really had too much to do this tournament. There's been very few goals scored against this side, and now he's going to be under some severe pressure from Northern Ireland. It'll be great to see how he holds up.
Well, Sterrett again with a barge in the back, and he just gets a nod from the referee there, who holds up two fingers to say that's two fouls that you've given so far. He needs to be a little careful. Number four here is Vilches. Going into the challenge, will Chile are going to have to show that they've got a physical edge as well, because as we've seen from Northern Ireland already in this tournament, they do not hang about. They do get stuck in, Tom.
Well, exactly, and we just saw another good diving effort by Grant Cameron. The pressure he's going to be under is going to be great, and you can see the rain as well teeming down on our camera. This is the wettest and wildest day we've had here in George Square.
Do you know what? Ironically, I think it's possibly also going to be the sunniest. It looks like it's going to be one of those days that's going to be raining. It's going to be sunshine, and the goals are going in for Northern Ireland. It's Johnny Sterrett who picks out the bottom corner.
This would be an incredible scout by the Northern Irish side. Here's another opportunity. Here's Spears, denied by Cameron.
Well, Mark Heaney is on for Northern Ireland as they make the first change. Going off was Gerard Bannon. And here's a young man with quick feet, although Chile, well, it's a blue card going the way of Johnny Sterrett, and that is for persistent fouling, surely.
Well, yeah, of course. Harry Milas, the Australian referee, wasting no time after he'd already warned Sterrett. That is 2 minutes in the sin bin as such for Sterrett. Big test for Northern Ireland now. They'll be under the cosh for the remainder of this half.
They certainly will. Chile will be desperate to hang on to possession and ping the trigger whenever they can. And Nicolas Munoz has managed to get them level at 2-2. The defensive aspect when you're down to the three men doesn't really change too much, but in an attacking sense, you don't have an out ball anymore. So that's going to be the difficult aspect for Northern Ireland.
Yeah, once they've pushed up, pushing back. Look, here we go. We've got 3-on-1 now.
It's Vilches, but saved by McGuinness. And a big ask now for Mark Heaney and Darren Spears. They've got a lot of running to do.
The rain is, in fact, coming down even harder, if that is at all possible. It's terrible conditions, torrential out there for the boys.
That will come the way of the number three. Manages to dummy the goalkeeper. And Northern Ireland survive as Lepe fires wide of the target. Chile probably should have gone in front there. Heaney. And you can see Spears already there with his hands on his knees. He knows that it is going to be a big task. They can't overcommit when the ball goes into the Chilean half. It's Vilches for Chile. Thought he saw a gap.
Just about 40 seconds left to ride out on that 2 minute punishment.
Well, that will pretty much take us to half time as we enter the final 30 seconds of the half. And if it can remain this way, you would have thought Northern Ireland would take that again. Another change, but remaining on the field at all times, is Darren Spears. It's Vilches back to Munoz, and struck by number five, Felipe Lepe. And Chile take the lead with 10 seconds to go in this first half. Spears now. Northern Ireland are back up to the full complement. Methven is on, and he's rejoined by Bannon as the halftime whistle goes. Well, it's Chile that lead by 3-2, but key there for Northern Ireland is that they didn't let Chile get too far ahead, just the one goal.
I think what's very important about this game is it's a big wake-up call for Chile to see what they're going to be facing in this tournament, because they have had a one-man overlap, not just in attack, but in defence as well, for 2 minutes of that game, and they only managed to creep to a one-goal advantage. It's going to be incredible to see what Northern Ireland can do when they've got a full complement on the pitch.
Well, here we can see some of the best of Northern Ireland. And it's that man, Darren Spears. That was the first goal. What a strike it was.
Foot like a die. And don't forget, a lot of semi-pro teams in the Northern Irish League are looking at these people. There's a few people been sniffing around Spears. We could see Spears in the Irish League next year.
Well, absolutely. I mean, you can see from him, he has that quality as a player.
Exactly, exactly. So don't forget, these players have experienced homelessness at some point in their lives, substance or drug abuse. Lots of different things have impacted and brought them to this tournament. But the footballing quality is sublime.
Absolutely, and it's Street Soccer Northern Ireland who look after this team. And they have a good tie-in with Street Soccer Scotland as well, chatting to David Duke yesterday, and he was saying how closely they work with their group in Northern Ireland. Chile, though, advanced through Munoz. Northern Ireland just couldn't get the ball under control, but it's hammered home. Marty Methven from a tight angle. It levels things up. We're at 3-3 here. Tough tackling. You know, the team's not taking this easy. And Methven is in again here. Great save by Cameron. Methven, who is the most advanced. Hammered home. What a strike it is from Gerard Bannon. And now Northern Ireland, with the full complement of four players, showing exactly what they're made of. They hung in when they were down to three, and now they've got four, they are making it count.
Of course, substitution for their goalkeeper. Northern Ireland usually bring on Jim Black in the second half.
Heaney across. Well, a couple of chances falling the way to Marty Methven. Vilches for Chile. Their first real big test. Vilches blocked and over the top. Black retrieving the ball. Sensible to get the cap in. It's certainly not to block out the sunshine, but that will keep the water off his face. It is very wet here at George Square. Heavy challenge indeed by Gerard Bannon. Northern Ireland don't want to lose a second player for 2 minutes. That could be very costly. Bannon must be careful. And finished off by Felipe Lepe. Picks out the top corner from the angle.
When I've been talking to the Northern Irish coaching staff, they've mentioned about how they've tried to get some controlled aggression into their game, and control is going to be important for them entering the last 4 minutes.
Vilches so close, hammering one off the inside of the post. Of course, a diving goalkeeper has to be so careful with one of those ones. Very easy for the ball to come off the post, off the goalkeeper's back and into the back of the net. So 4-4. Well, and we can see in particular these last two games in the men's competition just how things are tightening up. So few easy games when you get to this stage, and we're not even at the knockout phase.
Of course, the top two of this group will go in to compete with a sort of elite eight for the Homeless World Cup at the trophy stage. And that Homeless World Cup final day will be on this Saturday here at George Square.
But the great thing, of course, is that everyone goes on to play some part in the latter stages. Whether you finish second, third, fourth, fifth, all the way down to sixth, and in either section of the draw there is a competition and a trophy available to all. Number three for Chile, and it just creeps outside the box. Well, the block came in from Munoz, and Jim Black had to react quickly to that one. Number five now is Lepe, who scored the goal that got Chile level at 4-4, 2.5 minutes left to go. Vilches back to Lepe. And hit by number three, Munoz, and that gives a great chance off the underside of the bar. Northern Ireland comes so close. David McConnell just a fraction away from putting his side in front. Higni is back on for Northern Ireland. The roll-in comes all the way across. So tightly poised. 2 minutes. Who can step up and win it? And Northern Ireland turning to their captain, Darren Spears, is back. And will it be Spears that can have the influence that can sway this game in Northern Ireland's favour? Chile have it though, with Munoz to Lepe. And it's still Munoz, Lepe and Velchez that are the three outfield players involved for Chile. Higni almost scoring from range. This is Lepe up the line, using a bit of power. Velchez, great turn, great finish. Fist clench for the Chilean captain, Matias Velchez. Chile, who went in a goal to the good at the break. Well, Darren Spears knocking his opponent to the ground. The two captains collide. And Spears telling his man to get back to his feet. Velchez feels that that perhaps should have been a blue card. How did you see it, Tom?
Look, just with a minute remaining, what I can see is a lot of aggression on that pitch. I can see not a lot of control. Northern Ireland need to calm themselves down. They've got a minute left to get a goal that could maybe force a penalty shootout here, and they can't afford to be mouthing off at the referee.
But there's plenty of control in that finish by Matias Velchez, which, as things stand, that is the intervention that is giving Chile the victory here. 5 seconds left, but I suspect there will be a bit of overtime after that confrontation between the two captains. Bannon, and he can't quite get the ball, and Chile now will look to just run down the clock, which they do successfully. Well, what a game between Chile and Northern Ireland. And it ends with a victory for the South Americans. They continue their winning run at Northern Ireland's cost. What a start to things in Group B.
Absolute heartbreak for that Northern Irish side. They're one of the teams that can compete, can overpower and can beat the biggest sides in this tournament. And that's a very unfortunate defeat. But all credit must go to Chile with some fine finishing.
Well, remember, you can donate to the Homeless World Cup by texting GOAL to 70660 for a £5 donation. And please get involved on Twitter using the hashtag HWC2016 at Homeless World Cup, no O in world. Facebook.com/Homeless World Cup, where you can watch all the games streamed live here from Pitch One. Also, YouTube.com/Homeless World Cup, where you can see all the highlights and videos around George Square. Another thrilling game coming your way. It's the hosts, Scotland in action against Denmark next.